to present to Eric Lindros, 2001 honored member Dale Hawerchuk.
As great as a hockey player Dale was, he's an excellent friend, and I'm honored to know him and know him well. Ladies and gentlemen, honored inductees, Hall of Fame members, it was a privilege to play in the National Hockey League, to play for Canada, and to play for the many teams I had a chance to be a part of along the way. It's humbling to stand here today alongside some of our sport's true legends to accept a place in the Hockey Hall of Fame. I'd like to thank the Hall staff, especially Kelly Massey, this year's selection committee, the board of directors, my many teammates through the years, coaches, trainers, doctors, billets, and of course, I'm so grateful for the unwavering support of hockey fans, especially Philadelphia Flyer fans. I would like to congratulate the other inductees, Rogie and Sergey, and of course, Kelly. This must be an emotional day for Coach Quinn's family, and I hope you find comfort in being surrounded by people who love the game like he did. I want to thank my family, my brother Brett, my sister Robin, and especially my mom Bonnie and dad Carl, who are often under the glare of the media. Every kid should be so lucky to have his parents, to have parents who aren't afraid to tell them all of their options. My parents offered me the guidance and direction they thought was best for me and allowed me to make my own decisions. They never wavered, even when those choices may not have been popular. They looked out for all of us, all their kids. We had a great game yesterday at the Legends Classic. It certainly was a lot of fun. It was slow, but it was a lot of fun. And fun is what hockey's all about. It was great to catch up with Borja Salming, and it reminded me of the first time I had a chance to meet Borja. I was about 15 years old and invited to skate with some pros at an arena in the east end of Toronto. I was a bit scared to get on the ice with guys that I had grown up watching on TV. Borja was there, and he could see it. He knew I was nervous. He sat next to me on the bench, and since it was the start of the year, I was wearing some new gloves. He asked me if he could try them on. I passed them over, he worked them in a little bit, and he told me that they were great gloves and I was going to have a great year with them. And just like that, I had broken the ice with an NHL star. A solid move to help an anxious teenager feel more comfortable and at ease. I have never forgotten that moment, and over the years, have tried to pay forward Borja's gesture. I was extremely fortunate to grow up in Ontario. I split time living in London, Toronto, and playing junior in Oshawa, cities where we are so blessed with strong schools, cities where the word volunteerism really means something, schools where science teachers double as school hockey coaches out of the love of sport. Some of my best memories are of this time, when I skated at the rinks like North Toronto and St. Mike's, the kind of rinks that are found in so many cities, rinks that are gathering points for our communities. When I was 10, I didn't play summer hockey. I played baseball or soccer. The rule in our house was we could go to hockey camp for 1 week prior to the start of the school year. So at the end of every August, I ended up in Scarborough at Larry Marson's hockey camp. As it turned out, Larry was later my assistant coach in Oshawa. We spent countless hours together for a number of years working on skating, one-timer passes, deflection, you name it, he helped it. He helped break down plays in my head and made me better. After I played for Philadelphia and I was still trying to stay sharp, Larry would meet me at the rink 4 days a week, showing up at 7 a.m. and putting me through the paces before going to his day job. Guys like Larry Marson and Ozzie Sherrard, who was my first hockey coach, might not be household names, but they are reminders of how many selfless people there are in the game who are so willing to offer their time. I love the backyard rink, the extra practices before school, the feeling of improving, the big tournaments like Silver Stick, the Quebec Pee Wee contest. With it came the feeling of success, but also of defeat. All of these are part of the valuable lessons and experiences hockey has to offer. I love the friendships that hockey helps to foster. I have loved playing in the rinks throughout the NHL, but I've also loved and continue to enjoy playing pickup hockey past years in the Toronto rinks with the same group of guys every Tuesday and Thursday. No other sport brings people together from so many different walks of life like hockey does. When it comes to friendships, some of the best I've formed have come with teammates. I had so many great teammates through the years. I'd like to thank them all and give special thanks to Johnny LeClaire and Michael Renberg for their intensity and joy and love of the game. I was lucky to be your centerman. This reminds me of a little story about Rennie. We were playing LA and Rennie kept sticking Marty McSorley, which was kind of crazy. And things were getting a bit out of hand. And I told Rennie on the bench that Marty was really getting upset and he's going to want to fight. And I couldn't remember the last time Rennie had fought anyone. So, well, the next shift, Rennie, of course, doesn't back down again. And sure enough, Marty's fired up. And I wound up getting involved. And it certainly didn't go well. Marty threw a yard sale with his jersey, his equipment, and I ended up in the penalty box. And as I'm sitting there across the ice in the box, I remember looking at Rennie, who was sitting on the bench, and he was just giving it that little grin with the little wave, saying, hey. My wife, Keena, and our three children, Carl, Pierre, Sophie, and Ryan, are the most important people in the world to me. My journey through the hockey world was a roller coaster, and there were times when I was left bitter. Keena has taught me balance. She has taught me how to let go of negative feelings. Since the time I started playing pro hockey until today, my life is as good as it's ever been. I've never been happier. I love you. Now I'd like to invite my brother Brett to come up here. It's a little off script, isn't it? Brett played in the island, and we always had a dream of playing together, and unfortunately it didn't come through, but I would like to close this chapter in my life with you beside me.
I appreciate that. Thank you. Right.
I'm enormously proud of this honor. With respect and heartfelt gratitude to you all, thank you.